Hey everybody and happy Wednesday. Today what we're going to do for our math lesson is we're going to draw a picture. But in your picture, I want you to include squares, circles, and triangles. So those three different shapes. You can use other things too, and you can add details and you can draw different parts of the picture, but there has to be a few squares, triangles, and circles. But here's the catch. Each shape is going to be worth a certain amount of money. So we've talked about money. And so the squares are going to be worth 5 cents, the circles are going to be worth 2 cents, and the triangles are going to be worth 1 cent. When we looked at our coins, I know that there isn't a 1 cent coin anymore. There's no pennies anymore. And there's no such thing as a 2 cent coin. There is such thing as a nickel, a 5 cent coin. But even though these coins don't exist for 1 cent or 2 cents, that doesn't mean that that money value doesn't exist. Because sometimes when we pay with a credit card or when we pay anything really, there still might be those amounts. We just don't actually have the coins to pay for them individually. But, so in your picture, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to include squares, circles, and triangles to equal 14 cents. So you're only going to have 14 cents to spend on your picture. And so for each triangle that you draw, you're going to have to buy a triangle for 1 cent. For each circle that you draw, you're going to have to buy it for 2 cents. And for each square that you draw, you're going to have to buy it for 5 cents. And when you're finished your whole picture, you need to have spent 14 cents. So here's Ravi's example that he worked hard on this morning. You can see that he used the black marker to show each time he used one of the special shapes that he had to buy. And then he used the blue marker to show all the extra little things that he added. So he used one square at the top there. You can see where he explained how many he used. So he used one square for 5 cents. He used four circles and he used one triangle. And then he went above and beyond and he even showed me all of the work he did to try to make sure, to double check that he had spent exactly 14 cents. And he used a lot of really great strategies that we're going to look at together. Ravi's picture here, and we're going to go through all the different strategies that he used when he was trying to add all of his cents together, all of the money that he spent on each shape together to see if it equaled 14. So the first thing that he did is he decided to figure out how much money did his four circles cost. And he knew the circles cost 2 cents each, and he had four of them. So he's going to add the number two for 2 cents four times. So he has two plus two, plus two, plus two. So one, two, three, four circles that each cost 2 cents each. Now what he did was he took this big long equation and he made it shorter into smaller equations that he thought were really easy to do in his head. And because he's getting super good at doubles, now that we've been practicing so much that we've been home, he knows that 2 plus 2 equals 4. And again, 2 plus 2 equals 4. So now what he has to do, all he has to do is add 4 plus 4, which again is like doubles, and 4 plus 4 equals 8. So he knows that for his four circles, he spent 8 cents. So if he takes those 8 cents and now he's going to add the square to it. So for the circle, he spent 8 cents. And now he needs to add the one square. He only used one square. So that was 5 cents. So he's going to try to do 8 plus 5. That one is a little bit tricky for him to do in his head. He could use a number line and do the hops forward. That's a great strategy too, or the hundreds chart. But what he decided to do was he decided to break down the number 5 into numbers that he knew would be easy to add to 8. So the number 5 can be broken down into the number 2 and the number 3. We know that 2 plus 3 equals 5. If we take that 2 and we add it to the number 8, we know that 8 plus 2 equals 10. So all of a sudden, we've gone from 8 plus 5, which is a little bit tricky to do in our head, to 10 plus 3, which is much easier to do in our head. So the 10, we add it to the 3, 10 plus 3 equals 13. So 8 plus 5 equals 13. But that's just a different way to do it. If you break down the number 5 into easier numbers so that you can easily make a number 10. And the last thing he had to do, so now he knows that with the circles and the squares, he has 13. And he only used one triangle, which cost 1 penny, 1 cent. So 13 plus 1 equals 14. So good job, Ravi. He drew his picture and he only spent 14 cents. Now I'm excited to see what creative drawings you guys can come up with that use circles, triangles, and squares that can add up to 14 cents. Have fun.